All right, I fell in love with Karen Allen for Animal House, as any thinking person did. Of course, you know her as the heroine from Indiana Jones, and now a novel, A Year of Life on the Sea. Tell me the title, I just said it all wrong.
A Year by the Sea.
A Year by the Sea. Karen is here this morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
People go over this filmography with you because it is extraordinary?
You mean
not every single one, but certainly Animal House or Indiana Jones or
those stand out. I mean, people, Animal House to this day has a a huge following. It's I call it the film that won't stop celebrating itself. But people love it,
yeah.
And I have to say it has aged extremely well. I watch it and I think it's as marvelous today as it was in the 70s when we made it, so.
And as we were looking at that swashbuckling fair with Indiana Jones, do you think that's aged as well?
I do. I this film is passed from, father to son to grandson to, it keeps on seeming to go down the line. I think it's just a classic sort of, story.
And this has happened with Indiana Jones once, this idea of, things being rebooted or reimagined. I don't think we would be well served by a 2018 Animal House, would we?
Well, this is the joke that we make. It would now be called Animal Home. we would all be like in sort of
a senior facility
living place together.
Okay. That's not a terrible idea. Talk to us about Year by the Sea. It's based on a book that people know.
It's based on a memoir written by Joan Anderson about her life, about a moment in her life when she was in her late 50s or kids had moved out of the house. One of them had just gotten married. She kind of looks at her relationship with her husband, and he's sort of very self-involved and still very much into his career. And she feels suddenly lost and doesn't really know what her life is going to be like going forward. So it's a transitional film. It's a film about a woman in transition.
A lot of people say that arguably among the most significant demarcations in a person's life is when the children go off to college and or when they graduate to college and go off into the real world.
Yes, and I think that makes it a very universal story because, we've all been through or will be going through that, or we've watched our parents go through that when we, it's a lot easier for the kids moving away than it is for the parents that they're leaving behind, because even if you're someone who hasn't put all of your work life on a back burner, you're still someone who is very, very, has been very involved in the day-to-day life and world and care and of your children. So it's a big shift. It's a big shift for everybody.
No question about that. Did you meet the author before you portrayed her?
I did. I met her not long after I was asked to do the film. She and I sat down to have an hour meeting, and 4 hours later we were sitting there just talking, and we immediately connected with each other. And she was, people say to me, she was on the set almost every day we were shooting.
Really?
And people say, wasn't it intimidating to have her there on the set? And I thought, well, it could have been, but she was not there to be a critical eye. She was really there to be a total support system to what we were doing. So.
Well, and here are the results. Take a look at this, watch.
Plateaued with age.
We don't.
Well, we're not there yet. However you look at it, getting old is more negative than positive. But that's the gift. Because the negative pulls are stronger, an aging person has to strive that much harder to gain strength.
And from adversity
comes transcendence.
The ninth stage.
Exactly! I wish I hadn't jettisoned that old typewriter.
You don't have one?
When I first started writing, Eric asked me to type him a letter, which I was pleased to do. Mm-hmm. But the very next day, he left me 4 more letters.
And what did you do?
I broke it.
Amazing women you're alongside.
Yes, that is the wonderful Celia Emery,
who's in Better Things, the Pamela Adlon show.
Yes, and Essie Payton Murchison, who we all know from Law and Order, and she's now on Chicago Medical. And yes, they play my partners in crime, so to speak.
Yeah. And when they said cut, my just sense and feeling is, out of character, you guys would have conversations.
The three of us?
Yes.
Well, we hit it off immediately. The director had the wonderful good idea to put us all, we shot this up on Cape Cod, to put us all in little cottages together. And within 2 or 3 days, we were just best girlfriends.
See, I've only been there once, but my sense about the Cape is that, unlike any other place, it glistens. Mm.
It does. It does. We were there in April and May, which is not the ideal time to be there in terms
cold,
of
chilly.
It was really cold.
Yeah.
It was really cold, and the wind just howls. Uh-huh. And you can look from the window. It looks like such a beautiful day, and you walk outside, and you're like, oh, my God, where's the parka? But it is so beautiful. I mean, what a magical landscape. And I had, even though I have a place in Massachusetts in the western part that I've lived in for many years, I just was not very familiar with the Cape. So. Oh.
Well, travelogue and much more. Film opens this Friday. Laemmle Theatre in West Hollywood, Encino in Pasadena, opens wide to select theaters on September 22nd. Karen Allen, what a pleasure.
Yeah.
Thanks so much.
Thanks.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here. Nice to meet you.
All right.